Keep filters is a calculate modifier that changes the way calculate applies filter arguments to the new filter context that is being created. By default, calculate overrides the outer filter context. And to do that, it removes the outer filter context on the column that is being filtered and replaces it with the new filter context. By using keep filters, calculate will keep the outer filter and add this, the new filter as a further filter. Let's see a couple of examples where it proves useful. In this first example, we have a measure white sales that computes sales amount and uses a product color equals white without keep filter. The result is that the value of white sales is shown everywhere, even though we have a filter by color silver or black or white. This condition overrides the outer filter context and always shows the white sales. By using keep filters product color equals white, calculate will not remove the outer filter. It will keep the outer filter and add the new filter as a second filter. Therefore, in this row, we will have one filter for silver that is still active because of keep filter, plus a new filter product color equal white. White and silver, they clash with each other. Therefore, the result is a blank. The only point where you have a value is when white is already in the filter context. Keep filters can be used as a calculate modifier, so inside calculate, but there is also another usage of keep filters, which is as a modifier for the first argument of an iterator like SUMX. In this case, keep filter will change the way context transition happens during the iteration. Its usage is kind of complex, but in this example, I will try to explain you the details of why and when it is useful. If you create a measure sales X that just iterates over the values of product color and computes the sales amount, this measure is relying on context transition happening here to compute the sum of the sales amount for all the colors. You can also write the same expression using keep filters values of product color. In a normal behavior, in a normal report, the two measures would return exactly the same value. But you might notice a difference if you are filtering using an arbitrarily shaped set. If you create a filter that contains 2008 red and 2007 white, what I'm doing here is I'm creating a table that contains one column for the year and one column for the color. The three tabs then changes in the year and the color, so that this table actively filters the date and the product table. Now, when context transition happens, if this filter is active, context transition will replace the filter on the color. By doing that, it removes both red and white from the table, from the filter, but what remains in the filter is basically 2008-2009. So by replacing the outer filter, calculate destroys the nature of the arbitrarily shaped set and creates a filter containing 2 years plus one filter containing one color. Therefore, the result will be wrong. By using keep filters, on the other hand, the outer filter, which is arbitrarily shaped set, is kept and the new filter is added. You can see the result here. Sales amount shows this value. Sales X, because of the way we wrote it, should return the same number. Instead, it does not. It shows a different value because this is computing the sales in 2008 and 2007, which are white. Similarly here, for red, we are computing the sales in 2008 and 2007, which are red, providing the wrong result. Using keep filters protects this code for being executed also in the unlikely scenario where you have an arbitrarily shaped set that is actively filtering your calculation.